Hey guys, so today I'm going to be filming my very first video. I feel kind of awkward right now because I'm not really used to talking to a camera, and my family's sitting up in the living room, which is like right beside my room, so I feel a little bit weird about this, but I just wanted to give it a go because I've honestly wanted to start a YouTube channel for such a long time. I've been a really big fan of watching YouTubers, and we're just gonna give it a go and let's just get into it. I don't know what look I'm doing or anything. I kind of think I'm just gonna do some random stuff, but yeah, so let's just start right now. First, I have to go with my beauty blender, so I will be right back. Okay, I have returned. Oh, I just ran over my foot in my chair. Okay, so I'm going to start off with priming. First, I will be going in with my Too Faced Hangover Primer. I have to dot this all over my face. Sorry if you see me looking over here. This is where my mirror is, and I know the lighting's really bad, but like I said, this is my first video, so rubbing in. I'm going to be going in with some, it's the Makeup Forever Step 1 Equalizer Smoothing Primer. I love this stuff. I love the smears all over my face. I love looking smooth. Who doesn't like looking smooth? I do not know. Who has pores? Nobody. So, have you ever put so much primer on that like your makeup starts to slip off your face? Because I have, because I love primer. And I kind of want you to know that like I know about makeup. I'll list my Instagram and all that fun stuff down below because I have actually had an Instagram makeup account a lot longer than like just right now, so I shall put that in there. Do we want to do some more primers? I think we do. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with Becca Backlight Filming Primer. I love using a lot of primers, especially when I'm gonna be wearing my makeup out all day, because it really helps it stay there. It really preps your skin for the makeup and makes everything look really, really good. So I like to put my glowy primers like where I want to glow. I just took way too much of this primer. Perfect. Sorry if you can't really see what I'm doing. Like, I have like a lamp right here because oh, I'm bleeding. Lovely. I'm gonna let all that jazz sit into my face, and I'm gonna move on to my eyes. But I normally use tape, so I'm actually not gonna prime my lids first. So I'm gonna be priming my lids with this Soft Ochre Paint Pot by MAC. I'll also list all the products down below in case I don't like talk about them. Hopefully I do. This is kind of like a chit-chat your video with me too. Like, this is sort of just like my first video, you know, letting you guys know what I'm all about and what I like and what I like to do. So on my eyelid. Yep. And a lot of beauty gurus, I see they do like one of their eyes like on camera and then they do the other eye off camera. I can't do that because then they won't look the same. I kind of have to do the same to each eye like as I go, or else they're just not going to look the same. So I can't do that, so sorry. Now I'm going to put the tape on my eyeballs. Is that where I want it? Yeah. Okay, I think it's good enough. We'll put it there. Oh, and I also just want to put a disclaimer out there. I don't want you guys to think that I think I know everything. I know that I don't know anything. I am not by any means a makeup artist or anything. I like to think I am sometimes, but I know that I'm not. So now I'm going to be going in with my Lorac Pro palette and taking these two cream white colors to set the lid. As you can see, I hit pan on them because I love these colors so much for setting my lid. They're really pigmented and they work really good, and I make sure that I don't crease, and that's what I like. So, and I really hope that I do this right, and I really hope that you guys can hear me. And yeah. Oh, by the way, if you guys don't know, I'm from Canada. I just thought I'd tell you. I don't know if you really care or not, but you know, I honestly don't see a lot of YouTubers out there from Canada. I know one, Rach Loves. She's really nice. Well, I think I've never met her, but you know, she seems really nice. She has a really good channel. Other than her, I'm not really familiar with many really, really popular YouTubers from Canada. Really just hers who I'm familiar with. But I mean, if there's more out there that are really, really great, you guys should like comment them below or something. That'd be really cool so I could watch some of them. Like I said, I love watching YouTube videos. I'll tell you some of my favorite YouTubers right now. Manny Anyway and Jeffree Star. Nikki Tutorials, Jaclyn Hill, Tina Halalda, Shelby Trig something? Trig, yeah, I don't know how to say her last name. Daisy Hernandez, something like that. Daisy. Who else? Oh, Lustralux and Desi Perkins. Love them. Take just like a flat like brush, like bonding brush thing. I'm gonna go in with my Juvia's the Nubian palette, and I'm going to take these two. I'm kind of gonna mix both of these middle shades on the top together and blend them into my crease. Juvia's Place eyeshadows are just really, really good. And I really, really love them. Do you know what I did? I forgot to do my eyebrows. Because I normally like do my eyebrows and then I like clean them up. And I already have powder on my lids, so I can't really clean them up anymore. Is it looking good? We just won't do an intense brow today. I promise I can do good brows, but we just won't do one today because I've already missed that part. So, I don't like how I should have done it on the other side, but this is my good side, so I wanted to put the light on this side, but then when I put my hand up, you can't really see what I'm doing because of the shadow, so I don't know how to go about this. And this by any means isn't a good camera either. I was gonna just film with my phone, but I had no space on my phone and I didn't want to delete everything off my phone just to have enough space to make a video. So I decided to use this camera. It's a Fujifilm XP waterproof camera. It's just like a little handheld one. I don't really know how it's doing, but hopefully it's doing okay. Oh, I didn't really tell you what brush I'm using, but this is an old BH Cosmetics brush that came in a set. This would be, like, I think it was, like, the Face Basics set. And it's literally just a flat top kabuki type of brush, but in, like, small eye form. But yeah, this is just from an old BH Cosmetics set. Now I'm going to be going in with... it off right quick on my bed, and this is a still Spa Essentials eyeshadow blender brush, and I got this brush individually from Walmart. They carry this line of brushes at Walmart, and I think they're really good. I have two of these brushes with some of their other brushes too. You can just buy them by themselves and just pick which ones you want, which is really nice, and they're really affordable, so that's really good too. Now I'm going to be going in with this brown color down here. I'm going to keep this color a little bit lower in my crease, but I'm still going to blend it up just a little bit to kind of mend them together. With me, my eyebrows are like way up here and the end of my lid's like right down here, so I have a lot of lid space, so I kind of have to fill it up as much as I can, so I end up bringing my transition color really, really high. It's gonna end up getting blended up a little bit anyway because I'm gonna still go in with a deeper color, so I still have some layering to do. I don't know what I would call. And if you guys ever wanted me to do like a makeup collection video, I would so do that because I know that I don't have a lot of makeup, but you know, like, people like to see what other people have. I know I like to see what other people have. And I watch a lot of, new YouTubers, and they never make videos on their makeup collection. But you shouldn't be ashamed that you don't have much yet, because you just started. Like, so if you guys wanted to see what a beginner's makeup collection would look like, I would do a video like that for you. I honestly can't even tell if this looks good. Like, I can't see. I don't know why. Oh, and if you're wondering, and just out of, if you have the curiosity, I wear contacts because I wear glasses because I'm blind as hell. So I never wear makeup with glasses because I can't see while I'm doing it. Like, I'm, like, really, really blind. Like, I have -8 eye and -6 eye. I don't know if you guys know, but that's, like, really, really bad. So, yeah, I literally can't see when I don't have my glasses on or contacts in, so I literally can't wear makeup and wear glasses because my makeup always ends up looking like crap because I could not see what I was doing. So, I never wear glasses and makeup unless I were to put my contacts in and take them out and then wear glasses after my makeup's done, but that would be like a waste of contacts, so I don't do that. Anyway. I'm just gonna go back in with this flat brush and just like blend those together with new extra product on my brush. Okay. Okay, no. No. I just got a glimpse of what it looked like. No. Just an O. Into the no. See what I'm doing. Okay, I'm just gonna have to like come over here for a second. Okay, I think that looks okay. Let's hope so. I bet you one side's gonna turn out bomb and the other side's gonna be like, huh, bye. I can see that happening. I just like to scrunch my eye when I'm blending. I don't know why. I just feel like I get extra blindness when I do that. If that makes any sense. Okay, this is a Still Spot Essentials Smudger brush. Oh, these have numbers too. Let me tell you the numbers in case you want to order online or anything. This is a 006 brush. This is the second brush that I used, the blender brush, eyeshadow blender. This is in 006, and this one is in 009, which is the smudger brush. And I'm going to be taking this dark brown. Darker than the other brown. It's almost black, but it's not. And I'm just going to be putting that on my outer V of my eye. I, like I said, I'm not doing any fancy looks, but I'll put my Instagram down below. No, I can do like more than this. Like, this is just like a simple like get to know me type thing. I don't really know if I'm even talking enough. Like, I don't know anything. So we're just testing things out. Now I'm just going to go in with the second brush I used, the eyeshadow blender. Oh, goodness. And I'm just running over that. I literally can't see anything. Like, that is just so bright. How does this look? Is this too not bright? Does this look weird? Like, if I just didn't have this at all, how would that be? How's the lighting here? How does this look for you guys? Is this too dark? It's probably too dark. Yeah, probably too dark. What if I face this up? How would that go? How's that? Is that okay? I don't know. Let's give this a go. Well, I don't know anything, so I'm just gonna try anything to see if that works. Oh, other eye. This seems really dark. Is this really dark? I can't tell. Like, honestly, you could be really bad at doing eyeshadow, and you can still make these shadows look good. Just saying. And then I'm gonna be going back in with the first two colors that I used. I feel like this lighting's better. Like, am I crazy? But I feel like this is better. So these two. Now I'm just gonna like breathe. Okay, so I just checked in. So far, so good. I think the lighting probably will look better with this lamp. So yeah, I'm just gonna bring it back into the picture. I'm gonna put it farther away though, because I don't like it being right in my face. It just invades my privacy. So I'm gonna put it over there. The last thing I did was I showed you the swatch of this color that I'm about to put all over my lid. Like, yeah, that just happened. I know. Now I'm going to be taking this Body Sparkly color in the palette, and I'm about to put that in my really inner corner and sort of blend it onto my lid. I'm just gonna put some lashes on now, get it over with. These are the Huda Beauty Gazelle lashes. I have them just sort of sitting here because they've been sitting here forever. They have fluffies all over them. They're kind of gross. This is just what they look like. So I'm gonna pop these on and I will be right back. Before I leave, I am going to mention that I have the Duo Brush On Adhesive, and it is the clear stuff. To blend those in, I'm going to blend my real lashes in with them using a sample size from Use Roller Lash and blend them together, and I shall be back again. Oh no. No, it didn't. Are you kidding me? I hope you're kidding me. Did that really just happen? To hide my lash band with a little bit of liquid eyeliner. This is the Arbonne liquid eyeliner. That could look ridiculous. I'm sorry, did not go how I planned. Okay. I don't like that. I don't. No. But we're gonna leave it. I'm going to be mixing my Too Faced Born This Way foundation in the shade Porcelain and my Smashbox Studio Skin foundation in the shade 0.5. Yep, 0.5. Okay, so what I do, I know it's summer, but I'm still really, really pale, and this is my palest foundation that I have. So what I do on the back of my hand, I do two pumps of this, and I do one pump of the Too Faced, and then I usually end up using more. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna blend them together. I'm gonna put the finger. Oh no! I think I had eyeshadow on that finger. I did. Oh well. Anyway, and I'm going to blend this foundation to my face. Oh, and this is a Morphe sponge. It's like the first one that they came out with. I love the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. My shade is the shade Fair 15. And then I end up mixing it with the Too Faced Born This Way Concealer in Fair because I have pretty much nothing left in this. And if you're wondering why it looks like I'm putting so much on, it's because I am. But it looks really good. It ends up highlighting like the rest of your face, which is really good. And then I kind of take this stuff, put it like a little bit. This stuff's also darker than this stuff, and it's not as bright as the other stuff. And that's where I put my concealer. And then I flip the sponge around, and then I blend it with my face first. Because my eyes crease really fast. My under eyes crease like super fast. I use the Laura Mercier Loose Setting Powder in the full size. Because, you know, I splurged a little bit on this stuff. Because where I live in Canada, I literally cannot find Coty Airspun Powder to save my life. And I also can't find the RCMA Powder. So, my only option. But it's a really bomb option. So, I use it in the... But I literally get it ready to go, and I blend like fast, but I make sure it's like still really goodly blended out. And set to roomy. like big with it. I'm gonna leave it like that. And then I flip it over because I now have powder on that side, and then I just tap, tap, tap. My camera just turned off again, so I'm sorry about that. Anyway, back to bronzing. I'm gonna have to figure out how to make sure that it, so it doesn't do that. Also, I have to figure out how to get myself in the middle. Okay. Face Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. This bronzer looks nice on like a lot of people. And it smells so good. So I'm going to use that to bronze my face. Brush from the BH Cosmetics set that I had. It's like an old one. It doesn't have a name on it. But it's like an angled like kabuki brush or whatever. And this is what I like to use to contour. I'm gonna take my Anastasia contour kit, the light to medium one, and I'm gonna take the middle shade Fawn, I believe it is. I don't really remember. Good. And I just cut my cheeks in half. Makeup Geek blushes that are still in like their little packagings because I don't have a Z palette, so I need to get a Z palette for these. But blush Infatuation. It's a nice neutral blush. I really love neutral blushes. I don't know why, but like they're really like I like blushes like these too, but they're still technically neutral. They're just a bit darker. But I could be very careful with these because they're not a Z palette and they need to be. But yeah, Infatuation is the name of this Makeup Geek blush. It just says blush, so I don't know if she has different formulas or not. But this is just says blush. So I'm gonna take that, and where I like to put my, I don't like to put it on the apples on my cheeks because I found out that makes my face get pulled like really forward. So I like to try to keep it on the back, like back a bit. And like blend it pretty much right above where I put my contour. Like I even like to keep like bring it back really far. I don't know why, I just do. Oh, and this is a Morphe R4 brush. I don't know if you can tell, but it's a Morphe R4 brush, just so you know. The brush that I'm using to put on my blush with. Okay. I'm going to be going in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Aurora highlighting palette. Now, ready? Are you ready to see how blinding this is? Try and get the camera nice and focused for it. Did you just see that? Okay, I'm just making sure because I don't know if it's just me. Freaking love this blush. Highlighter. I freaking love this highlighter. Because like I find when you do your highlighter last, it kind of just looks like a stripe on your cheek. So I like to go back in with my blush brush and just blend. I'm going to set my face with the Urban Decay All-Nighter Setting Spray. Yes. Take a little bath in that. Now I'm just gonna go in and finish my under eyes. Pretty much all the colors are blended into my crease and just. Now I'm just gonna put a bit of mascara on the bottom lashes. I will be done with my Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in the shade Medium Brown and the Anastasia number 12 brush. Lip kit in the shade Ginger. Because why not? Okay. So I believe this is the finished look. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Thank you for sticking along with me for my very first YouTube video. I hope it wasn't too hard to watch. But yeah, I tried my best. I'm going to keep on trying my best, trying to get better. I thought this was a lot of fun. Really good first time filming. I hope everything turned out okay. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below with any questions or suggestions or anything like that. So, yeah, thanks for watching. I hope you liked this video. And yeah, bye guys.